To be on the safe side, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because I tend to ramble. Beauties and welcome to my channel. Guess what we are doing today? Another eyeshadow palette collection and declutter. And today I am working with my drugstore palettes and Makeup Revolution. that's basically the bulk of what I have. So yeah, I have, as you see, a bunch of stuff, and I will go through it and all that. These usually are longer videos, just so you know. You have been warned. So let's just get into it. Let's start with AliExpress first. And I kind of grouped them underneath drugstore because of the price. That is basically it. Because a lot of the times there are only a few brands that I can physically get in a drugstore here. And that is Essence. That is some stuff from Revolution and iHeart Revolution. Catrice, Rimmel. And then that is basically it. So yeah. Let's start with these. These are from Beauty Glaze. Let's start with this one, because this was actually the first one that I bought from Beauty Glaze. These are all the Beauty Glaze ones, and this one are Huda Beauty dupes. So this is what this one looks like, which is called Mars. It is a very, very nice quality, and this was for a long time the red palette that I grabbed if I needed, for instance, a red shimmer. However, I have red shimmers now, so I'm going to pass this one along. Then we have these, which can also be bought in a bundle. Let's start with the Melon. And the Melon looks like this. I do have all these shadows though. I am going to pass it along. And the quality of all these is very, very good, but I know myself, I'm kind of like, yeah, but maybe I will use it, but I will not. And if I am using this, I'm not using my Jeffree Star one, which I need to use as well. So I'm going to declutter this one, and I need to change my battery, I see. So let me do that first. Yes. Okay, battery change. Let's get on with it. Here I have the Lemon palette, which is an all yellow palette, which is actually a very nice palette. Where am I there? A nice palette as well. I don't like the pressed glitter in the center though. I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to decide later. Let's go to the Berry palette. I did do videos with all of these though, just so you know. It's a very happy palette, but will I use it? I don't think I will. I'm going to pass this one along, the Berry. Yeah. And then we have the Mint, which looks like this. It is just a very weird color story. I bought them in a bundle. So yeah, will I grab it? No, I don't think I will. It's very limited to what I can do with it. So I'm going to, while the quality of all these is really, really good, I'm going to pass this one along as well. Then lastly, we have the Mia Oul Spring palette. And this is also a Huda dupe. And this is such a hidden gem, this palette, because it's I don't know if you can see that, but it's very sturdy. It has a nice magnetic closure. It has a very good mirror in it. And it just feels like, well, a pretty pricey palette. And it was not. So let me remove that. The quality of this is very, very good. Will I grab it? No. Just because of the fact that I have this strewn about my collection. But this is, especially if you want to start with color, such a good palette to start with. It is just amazing. So I am going to pass this one along. Okay, these two palettes here are from You Can Be. The Nirvana Rebirth and the what's it called again? Magic Spell eyeshadow palette. I did a video on this one. I did not do anything with this one except swatch it. The shades I swatched are these two. These two are, for me, what makes the palette. But, I keep thinking, I will use it, I will use it, I will do a video, I will do a video, but I won't. I just have to be honest with myself, but also with you. I think what I will do is I will sanitize these two shades with alcohol and just spray a little bit of alcohol on it a little bit more and then just pass it along, because I'm not going to use it. Then we have this one, and I did a video with it. It is a nice palette. It's a nice quality. It is not amazing. It is very beginner friendly though. Just because of the fact that the shades are not overly pigmented. They're not really sheer. They are a little bit better than sheer. They are buildable. They are easy to blend. They just did not blow me away. I did not expect it to, but this is kind of what you start with when you swatch. I can build it up. I have a different finger, but it does not matter. I can build it up. I can kind of get it through to pan. So if you are a beginner, this is a very nice palette to check out. If you like the color story, I think the color story is very cute. The shimmers are, yeah, they're okay as well. What am I going to do with this palette? I do really like the color story. Am I going to grab it? I don't think so. I kind of, on one hand, I want to do a video with it. But on the other hand, I don't have time, or at least not now. I'm going to hold on to it for now, because I do really like the color story. And the quality is nice enough for me to hold on to. Let's go to Essence. Oh no, let's go to this one first and then go to Essence. This is Primark. This is their Berry palette. This was the first eyeshadow palette that I bought from Primark. It's a very nice quality. I liked the color story a lot. But this one only has, I think, two true mattes. This one and this one. The rest are kind of shimmery formulas. I'm going to declutter this because I never ever use it. And while the formula is very, very good, very beginner friendly as well. So if you have a Primark near you, I don't think that they sell this anymore. But if you have a Primark near you, it's definitely worth checking out their eyeshadow formula. Because that is really, really nice. I am going to pass this one along to someone else though. Okay, let's next go to Essence. Let's start with this one, the Be An Original palette from Essence. Okay, so this one and the one below it, the other orangey one, was a present, an early Christmas present, not last year but the year before, from my husband and my son. And that was so cute. They just got me a bunch of Essence goodies that they thought looked cute and that they thought I would like. While I do like this color story, the only matte that I have here is this red. The quality is very nice. It survived my last declutter just because I got it from them, but I do think I need to pass it along, especially this one, because it is a bitch to store and I don't use it. So it's just, you know, sitting on my shelf going bad. Well, maybe someone else will have a lot of fun with it, you know? But I am going to finally let go of this. This one then, the Born Awesome by Essence. They are no longer sold here in the drugstores where I live, but the formula is very, very nice. I don't grab this at all. But it is very unique to my collection, just because of the pans, because I got it from them. And I like the color story. The quality is very, very good. I could use this as a highlight. I am going to keep this, even if it's only for sentimental reasons. Okay, the next two are from their travel series, the Salut Paris and the Hello New York. I did videos on both of them, and I think that the Salut Paris is actually one of my best watched videos. Okay, as you can see, the palettes are pretty light. It's just, yeah, it is the way it is, and I don't know why I have two of the same colors here. There shouldn't be, but there are. These palettes are very beginner friendly. They are easy to work with. The colors are not really in your face. They are kind of, I don't know, safe colors for me at least. I like this one the best actually, because I have a little bit more variety. And this color spectrum is speaking to me a little bit more. What am I going to do, guys? Am I going to grab them? No, I don't think so. I think I'm going to keep the Salut Paris. And pass along the Hello New York. Actually, I want to pass the Salut Paris along as well, because I won't use it. I'm kind of thinking I want to keep at least a few Essence palettes for if I want to do a full face of Essence makeup. Currently, I have then one in my collection, but there are some palettes that are coming out from Essence that I kind of like. Yeah, I'm going to declutter it. Yeah, I know there are palettes that Essence is coming out with that I really would like to try. So I am going to declutter that one, because I need room, guys. It's just... Oh. Okay, let's go to this one next, which is from Rimmel. It is their Magnifies Color Edition. Yeah, it's a nice quality. It was not worth the money, in my opinion, though. This kind of retails for... What was it? 17, 18 euros? I'm sorry, guys, but it's just not worth that. It's nice, though, but I only have 1, 2, 3 mattes. The rest are shimmers. I don't use this. I don't grab this. This blue is not flattering on me at all. So I'm going to declutter it. That felt good. Okay, let's go to ColourPop next. I bought the purple one and the rest were gifts. So let's start with these then, with the purple one. I actually bought the purple one because of this shade Chiclet, which I thought was a nice, where am I? Was a nice dupe for the purple shimmer in the Paulina palette, and it is. That is my favorite shimmer. This one is also cute. What are you doing? I don't know. This one is so dry. It's just insane. I don't know why it is so dry. It kind of blends out nicely. But yeah, overall, it is a nice color story. Let's go to this one, the pinky one. I think the color story of the pinky one is very, very cute. Especially if you combine it with the purple. Here we have the Just My Luck palette. And I was so excited about this. Unfortunately, the shade that I love the most, which is this one, is actually a terrible shade to work with. So yeah, it's very, very patchy. I need to be so careful when I'm working with that shade. Because it gets patchy really, really quickly, on me at least. So yeah, there is that. But I do really like the color story. I think that these palettes are cute. I don't use them a ton. I probably don't use them enough. But I do want to hold on to them for now at least. I do have to say though that I think that the ColourPop formula is really overhyped. There are nice shades in here, but there are also terrible shades. So let's talk about this one then, which is the Good Sport palette. I heard people rave about this and I was like, I need that. I love the color story. It's supposed to be the best formula ever. Well, the formula is okay. The shimmers are nice. But the very first time I used these two shades are just bad. They are just very, very bad. And I don't get why people can say that they are not. Really? Wait. I need to swatch it on the inside of my arm. That's better, I think. So, first off, the shades feel really, really dry. I know swatches don't say anything. But this is also how they behave on my eyes. Very, very patchy. And just not really good. They were not buildable. They were, and it's not that I put 5 layers of eyeshadow on. You know, usually I kind of put one in the crease, but then leave a little bit of space for a darker shade that I want to use. I could not layer these purples. They were bad purples, people. But overall, the palette is very nice, and I did some very nice looks with it. It's just that these two shades were not good at all. But then again, the rest was. So yeah, I am keeping it. But it is not as good as people led me to believe. I think that is a better sentence. Next, I have BH Cosmetics. The formula of BH Cosmetics is very beginner friendly. At least the Zodiac palettes are. Let's start with the big one, which is the Love Signs. The quality is very, very good. The shimmers are very foiled. The mattes are very soft and creamy. Very easy to work with. I love the color story as well. I don't use it often. But I do want to keep it. It was my first BH palette. If you like the color story, it is definitely worth checking out. So I'm going to keep that one. Okay, so here I have the Zodiac ones. And I only got the Zodiac ones that I kind of liked. So I got the Aquarius because I'm an Aquarius. My son is also an Aquarius. So I needed this palette. Is this my color story? No, not at all. this brown, while very, very pretty, it is just, I don't know, not dark enough for me almost. But it is a pretty brown. But yeah, overall the rest of the palette is just, yeah, it's not my color story. But again, because it was, I am an Aquarius and my son is one, I wanted this. I'm going to keep it for now. I don't know who to pass it on to be quite honest with you. Then we have the Pisces. And this one was a little bit more exciting. Oh, I don't have the sleeve. This one was a little bit more exciting for me. This one was a little bit more colorful. Yeah, it's just, you know, such a shame that this, the mini palettes kind of flopped. Because I had real high hopes. Now, this was my red palette, the Aries. And I still really like this color story. I am going to keep all of these, for now at least. Here I have the Taurus. And there was, I think I liked the Virgo as well. There were a few others that I really liked. So here we have more of a greeny palette. And again, I really liked it. And they will stay with me at least for a little while longer. Because I kind of wanted to collect them all, you know, like Pokemon. And I really thought that I would. But then they kind of took a wrong turn. And I was like, yeah, it's just such a shame, you know. Okay, let's next go to Makeup Obsession. Okay, this is their Halloween palette from last year. the Take It to the Grave. I did videos with all of these. I really like this color story. The formula is nice enough. It is not as good as their palettes that they are coming out with now. That are on the bottom. It's not as good as that, but I do really like this color story and I had a lot of fun with it. So I'm going to keep it for now. These, I don't know, in my mind kind of go together. The quality is very, very good. Definitely worth checking out if you like the color stories. I don't think you will be disappointed. And the formula is very nice for a beginner as well. The palettes are not expensive, or at least not in my opinion. This silver, oh, can I just swatch this silver? Of course I can. It's just, oh. This one I really like as well. This is actually, I don't know what kind of color this is. A black with a red shift almost. It's a very pretty, deep, dark, unique color. And it's gorgeous to use in an all red look. I am in kind of a conundrum. And why am I in kind of a conundrum? I don't think I will use this one as much. I don't think I will use this a lot, but I think I will use this less. So, if I am being very truthful to myself, I should declutter this one. And I thought I would like this one more than I truly do. So, I think I am going to declutter the Intoxicated with Love palette. Well, the quality is really, really good. Just color story wise, it is actually not speaking to me as I thought it would, and I just kind of want to really curate my collection down a little bit and also kind of make room for, well, basically new stuff and room in my head for new stuff, because this is pretty unique. This color story is pretty unique in my collection, so I'm going to keep this one. Now let's go to my newest edition from Makeup Obsession. I just did videos with this one. This is the So Dope palette. This is such a good quality. It is definitely worth checking out if you're a beginner, because the shadows are very, very nice. They're very easy to work with. The shimmers are gorgeous. Guys, I just did videos on this. This is not going anywhere because I love this palette to bits. Then my very, very first palette that I got from Makeup Obsession. It's the Dream with a Vision palette. And this is such a good palette. This was my first pastel palette. But it is not only pastels. It also has a little bit of more brighter shades in here. It is just such a good formula. This teal is so good. It is such a good teal. It swatches terribly now because my arms are weird. Let me... Oh yeah, and this white. Oh, let's swatch them here then. So the teal. So good. If you like these shades and you want an easy palette to work with, grab it. Because it is definitely, definitely worth it. Okay, so those were the... Yes, that was that. Let's go to Makeup Revolution next. Before I go to iHeart Revolution. So this was actually a gift from last year. I think it was because they had 1 million followers on Instagram or something along those lines. 1 million, I don't know, millionth palette. I have no freaking idea. Millionth customer, I don't know. But this was a gift with purchase. It was limited edition. I could not find it on their site anywhere. This is what it looks like. It survived one declutter just because of the fact that it is an amazing quality. The color story is pretty as well. I just don't use it at all. So I'm going to finally pass it along. Let's go to this. I have two reloaded palettes here. Yeah, I do. So let's talk about the two reloaded palettes. This was the last one that I bought. It is their Blackout palette. It is, well... Basically, kind of the same as the Black is the New Black palette. The Black is the New Black formula is better, but I do also really like this color story. And this has a lot of options. I actually used this in my special effects look last year. So I am going to keep this one. Yes, I know I technically have another kind of a... I'm duping myself with this palette right about now. But still, yeah, it is a very nice palette. And there are some shades in here that I don't have in my Makeup Obsession one. So I am going to keep this. And this is... what's this one called again? Iconic Division. And it is their dupe for the... What's it called again? Subculture palette, I believe. These palettes are nice beginner palettes as well. Because the shades are very, very buildable. They are maybe a little bit sheer to begin with. But they are very, very buildable. So let me put it here. So yeah, easy palette to work with, safe palette to start with. Will I grab it? I don't know. Let's put it in the maybe pile. Okay, let's go to this one from Revolution Pro. I don't like this palette. I used a few, but they did not blow me away at all. And the trouble is, I have so much colorful palettes that this just is not what I am grabbing. This is a safe palette to check out if you are new to color. It's an all matte palette, but Revolution does have better color palettes. Or maybe even check out Makeup Obsession. I am sorry, but I just don't like this palette a lot. I am going to see if I can give it away to someone else. And maybe I am just spoiled, you know. It could very well be that as well. Let's get this palette out of the way because she's very shiny. It is the Extra Spice palette from Revolution in collaboration with Soft Dust Nails. Or Soft Dust Life, I believe she's called now on YouTube. This is a very nice palette. This is a very, very nice quality palette. It's definitely a beginner's palette, but it's also a palette if you are more advanced. It's just a very good quality. And I got this palette because I wanted a yellow. I did not have a yellow and I wanted a red. That is why I got this palette and I saw it online and I was like, I want it. This was the palette that kind of got me started on my journey in color. I'm going to hold on to it. Because first off, it has sentimental values, the quality is very good, and I just hope that I will use it more. Okay, let's go to my two pressed glitter palettes then. So, yeah, when I look at these, I get happy, but I never, ever use them. Never. In the 2 years, is it 2 years? Almost 2 years that I have these, I think I used these twice, maybe three times. I wish these were shimmers. I did not know that when I bought them because I thought, ooh, nice and sparkly. I didn't know that I would not really like pressed glitters, but I don't really like pressed glitters. So I am going to pass these along. I think my sister was eyeing these, but I'm not sure. I'm going to pass them along. Here, the Emily Wants palette. I also had the Needs that kinda I gave to my sister in the last declutter because I never used it. I wanted to use this one. I wanted to do multiple looks with this one, but I haven't, and I won't, guys. I just won't. I think that the color story is nice. I think the color story is actually pretty. I just don't use it. There are a few shades here that grab my attention. This row kind of grabs my attention, but that is basically it, and it is actually a shame. I am going to pass this one along. It's not a bad palette, at least not in my opinion. It is an easy palette for a beginner, but for me, I think I have outgrown it, and it has, I think I used it twice, and that's just a shame. I will not use it, so I'm going to pass this one along as well, and that feels so good. Okay, let's see, where can I, this was Keep. This is Declutter, so let's do that. Let's put Keep there. Yes, okay. Let's go next to my chocolate bar palettes that I have here. This is the Rose Gold Mini. The color story is cute. Very, very cute. And I wanted to use it. I just didn't. And I was planning on doing multiple looks with this, or at least a few looks with this. I was planning on using it more. I'm just not. You know? So, oh, and it is also broken, which annoys the hell out of me as well. Yeah, I'm going to see if someone wants it. Because, yeah. Okay, so let's go to... This one is newer. Let's go to this one, which has kind of survived some declutters. The packaging is broken. This is what she looks like. This is actually the Chocolate Nudes. Let's flip it so you can read the shade names. It's not a bad palette at all. But you can see kind of it has been damaged because, yeah, it broke. It annoys the hell out of me that these palettes break so quickly, or at least I break them so quickly. So, well, I try to be super careful. Yeah, this is what happened. So I am going to, maybe I'm even going to get rid of this just because I don't even want to give this to my sister, you know, because it is just broken and I don't know. Or shall I put it in my SFX kit? But will I use it there? No. If I put it in my FX kit, it will go bad because I don't use my FX kit that often. I'm first going to see if there is someone who wants this. If there's no one who wants it, I will either toss it or I will put it in my FX kit. Or maybe put it in my FX kit and then see, like, I don't know. Let's go to these two. So this is the red velvet. I haven't used it a lot. Are you still in one piece? Barely. I haven't used it a lot, but... Oh, look at that fucking packaging. The color story is cute. There are some very, very pretty shades in here. The thing that annoyed me about this one, though, was that it was called red velvet. And the outer packaging was red and white. And I do not have a red in here. And that is what was really pissing me off, if I'm being completely honest with you. And while the shades are cute, I haven't used this since my last declutter. I think I only used it when I bought it. And that's a shame. So there are some shades in here that are very pretty, but I am going to give it away because it's just, I don't use it. You know, it just doesn't speak to me enough to want to keep it in my collection. Okay, here I have the peanut butter cup. This one spoke to me more. But again, I have not touched it. These are beginner friendly. Just let me just say that the chocolate bar palettes are beginner friendly. I really like the color story on this one. I just don't use it. This is sometimes so difficult. I kind of want to keep hold of it, but I also not. Does it make me happy if I keep them? No. I'm going to marry Kondo. That is what I agree with her about. Keep what makes you happy. I agree with that. So yeah, that's a good one. For the rest, I know how to kind of declutter. But if it does not make me happy, it should go. This is the slime palette. It was their Halloween release last year. I do really like this color story. I have not touched it though since I used it in my first impression. Yeah, and I haven't touched it since. I thought that the quality was okay. I do think that some of the other palettes, especially the peanut, the other chocolate bar palettes that I have are actually better quality than this one. But I really, really liked it. What am I going to do with this one? I'm kind of looking at the palette to see if there are shades in here that I don't have. But no. I'm going to pass this one along as well. I don't have... I've only had this for a few months, but I have not touched it since. And if I am being truthful to myself, I will not. And then there are other bigger palettes that I would rather keep. Okay, let's go next to my other iHeart Revolution palettes. These are the Tasty palettes. These two I bought myself and the rest is PR. So let's go to the Avocado palette next. I'm being very careful. These seem to be a little bit sturdier than the chocolate bar palettes, though, or at least easier to store. This one is not going anywhere, guys. I just compared this one to the So Dope palette from a Makeup Obsession. They are very, very similar. I think that the quality of the Makeup Obsession palette is a little bit better than this one. But if you don't like that theme or whatever, check out this one. This is not going anywhere. This is a very, very nice palette. I am keeping it. The Popcorn palette is also very, very cute. And it's a very nice quality. These palettes are also very, very nice quality. This one is just... This is a palette that makes me happy. What can I say about it? I'm going to keep it. I did multiple looks videos with both of those palettes. And next we are going to go to palettes that I have not used as much. Here we have the Tasty Pizza, which is dirty. But then again, everything is here. I love this color story a lot. This color story is pretty unique in my collection. Just the way that it is laid out. It is staying at least for another declutter round. I do want to use this one more as well. Because I, again, like the color story. Here I have the Coffee palette. Which is a very soft, almost neutrally pastel. So here she is. As I said, very soft. Very beginner friendly. Will I use it a lot? I don't think so. But I'm not sure yet, because my neutral journey is just beginning, actually. I do want to keep hold of it for now. The quality is nice, but I think I already said that the quality is nice on all these palettes. I will probably use them or keep them all, though, I believe. Unless something funky happens, but well, you never know with me. Here I have the Hot Dog palette. Oh, it still has its plastic thingy. Wow, I was being so good. This is also a pretty unique color story for me because it is kind of a warmish neutral. No, yeah, it's kind of a warmish palette, but it's also kind of off. So yeah, I like it. I am going to keep hold of it, but I just wanted to show what it looks like on the inside. This is the chili one, and it is also very nice quality. And I am also going to keep this. That's the reason that I decluttered so many of the, or actually all of my chocolate bar palettes, because I knew that I almost knew for certain that I wanted to keep all of these. And if I then also have the chocolate bar palettes, it's just, I don't know, too much, if that makes any sense. So yeah, so let me go through these then. The lemon palette from Beauty Glaze. I do want to hold on to this one because this is a unique palette in my collection. So I am keeping this one. And then this one from Revolution. Will I use it? Truthfully, no. No, I will not. So I'm going to pass this one along as well. So yeah, the bulk of my declutter was in my Revolution palettes. So there I have... This is what I'm decluttering. I think I forgot... Didn't I forget palettes? Oh, really? Lord, I forgot 3 palettes. Wow, that is so bad. I forgot these. Which are from Soda Makeup, which are new. I am not going to declutter them. I did videos. I will show them to you very, very quickly. They are new in store for us here in the Netherlands. This is one of their quads. It's number 3. Yeah, number 3 mermaid eyes. This is what she looks like. And I can use it as a face palette too. I use this as a blush. I use this as a blush topper. I haven't used it on my eyes as of yet, but I will. Staying. This is the... Is this the first palette that I bought? No, this is the palette that I got. This was PR, by the way. This one. And this one was PR as well. This one I did buy when they were new. I even had to open the tester because they were just in store. This is the palette that I got first. And it's a very, very nice quality. It's also very beginner friendly. So if you live here in the Netherlands, you want to begin with... you want to begin your eyeshadow journey, these are very good value. They also had another one which was all neutrals, which was not really my kind of neutrals, so I did not get that one. So yeah, very good quality. I did one video with this colorful palette. I did one video with the next one that I got in PR from them. But this one also very good quality. Let's go there. Very good quality. I actually did quite a bold look with this one. So yeah. These are staying, and I was also kind of filming a little bit more with these. So these are staying. So now we had everything from the drugstore. This is what I'm decluttering. I'm having very much second thoughts about this one. The Intoxicated with Love. I'm having so many second thoughts. Yeah, I'm going to pull it back out. I'm going to keep this one, the Intoxicated with Love, for just a little while longer. And we will... regroup with the next declutter. Yeah, because that was the palette that I was really... Ooh, no, do not. That was the palette that I was really like, I don't know. I actually want to keep it. And the rest, I am good with decluttering. So yeah, that was it. That was everything in my eyeshadow declutter. Let me know down below what you thought of it. Oh yeah, and if I decluttered your favorite, don't be mad. It's not you, it's me. I don't even know why you would get mad if I declutter your favorite palette. But yeah, that's also me. That was it, guys. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.